The Application Builder allows you to develop both internal and public web-based applications on top of your Baserow database or other data sources. This video focuses on data manipulation. There are three kinds of data manipulations in software development, which are creating, updating, and deleting records. The Application Builder only allows creating new records and updating existing ones. In this chapter, you will learn how to embed and create forms, respond to events with actions, create and update records, and offer feedback to the user. The database has a table for volunteer information with three text fields for name, phone, and email, a single select field for indicating the type of driver's license, and a Boolean field to specify if the volunteer wishes to receive event invites via email. The homepage of the Application Builder presents an overview of the volunteers with on top a link to a new page for adding volunteers. There are two methods available for adding a new record through the Application Builder. The first method involves creating a form view in the database and embedding it using the iframe element. The second method designs the form within the Application Builder and sets up an action to respond to the submission event of the form. Let's have a closer look at both methods. The Volunteers table in the database contains a form view, allowing the user to create a new record. This form contains all required fields and is shared to be publicly accessible. Its mode is set to survey, ensuring consistent height for the form regardless the addition of any fields later on. Copy the URL of the shared form and navigate to the Add Volunteer iframe page in the Application Builder. Insert an iframe element on the page and paste the URL into the corresponding field. The form instantly appears within the iframe. Click the preview button in the upper right corner to test the form by adding some test data. Upon submission, verify in the Volunteers table that the new record has been successfully added. The second method to create a new record involves building a form within the Application Builder. A form is an element that can be added to a page and has a submit button. The submission of the form triggers an event, allowing an action to respond. The form element currently supports three field types: text input, dropdown, and checkbox. All field types have a label, a default value, and a required property. Text fields also support type validation and multi-line input. Examine the three text fields for the volunteer's name, phone number, and email. The name and phone number fields accept any value, while the email field requires a valid email address. Next, inspect the dropdown field, which is based on name-value pairs for selection. The value, not visible to the end user, is stored in the database, while the name serves as a descriptive text visible to the user, but not stored. Lastly, look at the checkbox field, which should never be required to prevent obligating the user to mark the checkbox. Select the submit button to assign an action to the submission event. Choose Create Row as the action. Complete the integration, database, and table fields as you would do for a data source. This now displays an overview of all the fields in the Volunteers table. Use the form data to populate the corresponding database fields. Click the preview button in the upper right corner to test the form and add test data for each field. Then click the submit button and verify in the database if the record has been added. The new volunteer is added to the database, but the user experience can be improved by immediately offering this feedback. Select the submit button again and add a second action to show a notification informing the user that the new volunteer was added. Finally, include a third action to redirect back to the home page, which serves at the root of the application. Test the new actions by clicking the preview button. It is important to remember that a single event, such as the submission of a form, can trigger multiple actions, such as creating a row, displaying a notification, and opening a page. Besides the creation of new records, the Application Builder also has an action for updating existing records. Both actions are very similar. The homepage's Volunteers table now includes an Edit button for each volunteer. Clicking this button navigates to the Edit Volunteer page and passes the volunteer's ID. On the Edit page, there is a data source that retrieves the volunteer based on the ID parameter, with the volunteer's name displayed in the header. The Form field displays the volunteer's information as their default values. This enables users to view the current information and easily make small changes, such as correcting typos. Click the Update Volunteer button and add a new action for the Submit event. This action will update a row, requiring the selection of an integration, database, and table. The main distinction between the Update and the Create action is that the Update action requires a unique row ID, which in this case is the volunteer's unique ID passed as a parameter. Other fields retrieve their values from the form fields exactly as with the creation of new records. Data manipulation with the Application Builder relies on actions that are triggered by events. The action can either be the creation or update of a record. The event is mostly the submission of a form or a button click. The Application Builder allows to manipulate data for external users that do not have direct access to the database. Therefore, it is crucial to think which manipulation should be allowed. Keep in mind that users always must receive immediate feedback after manipulation. This feedback can be done with a notification or a redirect to a page with the updated data.